Hello, this is the Lego NEXO Knights Battle Suit Macy. I'll show you all five of the NEXO powers included with this a little bit later on, as well as the minifigure that's actually buried inside of the body of this thing. But for starters, I actually want to show you a slightly different angle of this to get a little more of the uniqueness of this particular figure. Or I guess I shouldn't say figure, you know, the mech. The whole thing kind of seems like a large action figure to me. But it's the shoulders. The shoulders are what stand out for me in terms of just the stance and kind of presence of this. How square they are, and then with the use, I guess just the angularity of it. You know, they're square, and then they have those pyramids, which are just rotated squares, especially if you look at them directly from above. But the rest of this, you know, is pretty straightforward and standard fare. The shield is exactly the same as they use on all of them, because that's just a continuous piece that they use for the combo powers. Legs are done the same. The feet, you know, we've got some points to the toes here, but there's nothing too special there. But the weapon, of course, changes from one to the next. It's Macy, so she has to have a mace, and that was a good choice to go with the actual large action figure, you know, CCBS series piece there up on the top. Yeah, I think this works out pretty well. It's obvious that it's hollow, but that also allows extra light to come through, so it kind of has a day glow effect to it. That's cool. And of course, with all of these, you know, the articulation is really good, and with just a regular bludgeoning weapon, of course, you can get any kind of pose that you want from this. You know, bring it way back, bring it all the way forward, you can bring it down to the ground, you can bring it, knock against the shield to taunt your enemies, bring it across the body. They have all of the movement that you could ask for. And the legs, you know, the legs are the same as all of these. You can get them into an actual moving pose. They'll actually stand up like that. You've got the waist articulation, which is very convenient. You know, just the system on the whole is done well for these. There's not too much variation from one to the mech, from one to the next. From one to the next, I almost mexed. I almost did that completely unintentionally. Got mech on the brain, that's good. But, you know, it works, but I think that this just doesn't stand out that much from the rest, except for the color and the large end of the mace itself. I do like this print here on the front, though. You know, it's a printed 2x2 tile. It's just it's a nice look, and I feel like that can be used outside of the context of NEXO Knights, because it's just a dragon. It doesn't have too much styling that's specific to NEXO Knights itself. Let's get under here and check out Macy herself. I don't know why I get extraordinarily strong classic castle and knights vibes from this, especially just the overall silhouette. I guess with the standard, you know, classic style and proportions of minifig body, but then with the large helmet, especially with the guard across the front, just has an older feeling to me. I really like these prints that they come up with for these battle suit versions of the figures. You know, they look like techno robes of some sort, you know? It's interesting to me. Of course, all of this can be rotated back to reveal the standard face. There is actually, that's probably a better look right there for her because of where the ponytail comes out, you know, looks a little bit more believable for her. And there's some prints to be seen around the back, which just follows that same style from the front, and an alternate face, of course. And you can take the hair off. This is not something that I've done before, but you know, that's a different way of creating a Macy. You just need to do that on a head that does not have an alternate face, because that doesn't work. I guess maybe you only look at it from one side, but you know, that doesn't work, but definitely gives me inspiration to maybe try that for some other character. You know, it has, from Star Wars, Aura Sing. Why did that not dawn on me until just now? It's a perfect piece for her. For NEXO powers, this set gives you Wrecking Ball, Iron Dragon, Battle Cry, this is Slime Blast over here, and a classic in Mightiness. This is another case of what I consider to be a fine set, or a good set. You know, all of these battle suits, I think, were designed well to begin with their foundation. There's nothing about this one that particularly stands out for me. maybe the print is probably my single favorite thing, that print on the front there. And it does have a good selection of NEXO powers, but of course you can just, you know, look those up online. So I think they've done a perfectly fine job here. I think that it's a good set, and if you're a fan of Macy, this is definitely one to get. If you're looking for the best set to get from Season 3 NEXO Knights on a limited budget, though, I would recommend taking a closer look at the other sets as well. You know, this is definitely going to come down to just personal preference, I think, from one to the next. Because again, there's nothing here that objectively, I think, will kind of make a decision for you. So let me know what you are thinking at this point based on what you've seen for the Battlesuit Macy. Leave a comment down below if you would like to. And I'm going to continue working, bringing you some more videos very soon. So I'll catch you then.